Here we go, boys. Looks like another guy wants to fight us. What are they thinking, bro? What is, look at him. Panic. Spec. 22. Dead? Oh my. Literally 1 HP'd.
What is up, everybody, and welcome back to episode 2 of Deadman Mode Apocalypse. It's still day 1, but I took a little break after getting the Draconic Visage and posting my first video. But we're back to grind. I'm grinding all night. It's currently 9:45 p.m. and I'm settling in for the all-nighter. If you're wondering how my baby's doing, you can see in my inventory, she's doing okay. Got her nice and safe. Draconic Visage still there. Once we get the money to attach it through OZEC, I think it's 1.2 mil, we will have a DFS after 75 defense, of course, but we will have a Dragonfire Shield. And boy, is that a good feeling. Now back to business. Here are our stats. We were working on agility when we got the Visage on my alt account, and that's where we will continue. Back to business, boys. Oh yes, guys, 50 agility. That should make the pyramid laps way easier. I made a huge mistake, guys. I had 20 minutes left, like 25 minutes, and I came here and I died. Big setback for our progress. Honestly, I'm just trying to get our 5k back, and if we can get one or two kills and get out of here, that would be awesome. Well, I noticed on my alt account the daily clock reset, and I got a starter pack with 5k and another sigil. On my alt, we got the Sigil of Preservation. It's actually pretty good. It is just like, I forget the name of the prayer in the main game, but preserve prayer, 50% longer boosted stats. So I went to go claim another starter pack on my main account, and we just got the Sigil of the Treasure Hunter. Sounds pretty good. 2x clue scrolls. I don't know if I really care about that, but it's cool nonetheless. Maybe we can sell it for 10k. Who knows? Well, if you check my health, I literally just got red barred and my grave disappeared, so I have no tuna. All right, honestly, I'm just going to try to kill this last one and book it out of here without getting one damage done. Wish us luck. Oh, yes, ladies and gentlemen, check that sweet pyramid out. 10k cash every time we get one. This is going to be some nice money. For those of you who didn't watch the Fresh Start World series, I literally grinded to 84, 85 agility. This is 10x, 10 times the XP rate, so this is nothing for me. And if we're making money at the same time, oh man, I'm loving it. Guys, I just turned in two pyramid tops and got 60k. Normally they're 10k each. If you really get 30k each, that is insane cash. We are going to be rolling in the dough. All right, moment of truth, guys. Did I really get 30k for that pyramid top? Oh my god, you get it's over. 30k per top. Dude, that is so much just pure cash. Well, two PKers came and attacked us, but we got away super easy. Anyway, 92k, guys. That is insane, bro. 92k and another pyramid top, so 120k from those four laps alone. I mean, we basically just found our moneymaker. Like, that is nuts. Oh my gosh, guys, I was not even recording, but holy crap. Look at our inventory. We literally just escaped the pyramid with no supplies, almost died for, oh man. Dude, that ruthless ranger just wrecks you. Oh my god, I'm so happy we didn't die. Thought that we could claim a new sigil on our other account. I got the Sigil of Death Strikes. It's 20% accuracy to all styles of combat against monsters only, not players. So I'm gonna see what I can sell it for. 59, dang, nice. And Sigil of Mobility, let's see if I can get 20k for this. Nope, this one's not worth much. 59k though for the other one, that's not bad at all. Sigil of Mobility won't even sell for 10k, man. No one cares about that thing. About to turn in another three pyramid tops. Look at that, 90k to the bag, boys. Let's go. Well, looks like we got our first fight, boys. I think we're gonna kill this guy. Look, he's running from us. He's magic based. This guy's dead, dude. He's magic based.
Big hit. Dead. 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 He's panicking so bad. Dead. Dead, he's dead. We just killed our first guy. Let's go! And that is why we trained up before. Time to check the loot chest. Wish us luck. 14k. Actually, Wizzy top, blue Wizzy hat, and red beads. We'll take it. Here we go, boys. Looks like another guy wants to fight us. What are they thinking, bro? What? Look at him. Panic. Spec. 22. Dead? Oh my. Literally 1 HP'd. Firebolt? What? There's no way this guy's firebolting. Dead. 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 Good fight. Let's go, boys. Another key. That easy, bro. And let's see how much coins. Oh. 70k. Just to the bag like that. Bro, so easy, guys. That guy, what? Like, chaos runes, firebolt, no prayer? I mean, dude, what was that guy thinking, bro? Second kill tonight, boys. We're just wrecking these guys, bro. And if I had that ruthless ranger sigil, oh my god, dude, these guys wouldn't even be able to hang. And the key, 9k, some revenant ether. Oh, our boy's been at revs. Yeah, just revenant ether, lobster, blood runes. Not bad, we'll take it. And I believe this should be, no, not that one. Nope, not that one. 60 agility, everyone. We can now do Seer's Village. That is big, big levels. Give that to Mr. Simon, and look at that, guys. Another 90k cash stack. So easy. Well, guys, I just had to tell you out, but look at that stack. 121k. I swear that took us like 20 minutes. And we have another pyramid top. When we finished that last lap, there was a guy at the bottom waiting for us. I guess he was AFK. I just dipped it the other way, and then he finally caught on. Tellied out, and we're safe at the bank again. And we got this funny guy on us, but I think we can outrun him. He's not very smart. He's gonna let us gap him. He's been big gapped. Let's just turn these in while we're here. Telly out, that easy. 60k cash to the bank. 63 agility, big level coming in. Now use this pyramid top on Mr. Simon and another 90k. Man, we're making some serious bank right now. Very nice. Not one PK that whole trip, and we're ending the trip with 6k to 65 agility. Some big gains this trip. Once again, hand this in. 122k cash to the bank. Let's go. Well, guys, you guessed it. I'm addicted to trying out new alt accounts for the immunity. I'm going to give this alt a different setup than I've tried with any alt. We're going to revs for the hour that we have protected. I'm going to try to use Chaos Runes to do extra DPS, and hopefully this goes really well. We get some drops and it works out. The game plan is actually very simple. I'm going to use fire this charge staff until we can do firebolt. and hope with the little passive proc we can do enough damage to get a good amount of drops. Wish me luck. Two things I noticed. Number one, I don't need sharks because we have such low HP. Number two, I just paid 100k that I won't get back. That's all right. Hopefully the drops make up for it. Well, I think I made a mistake going mage for revenants on this alt because we really can't out DPS anything except for the imps. There is level 15 hobgoblins over here, but they spawn or respawn really slow. Nevertheless, we are going to finish out this 47 minutes strong, hope for some good drops, and then, you know what, guys, I'm going to bond up another alt. I don't care. And you guys already know, while we finish up the last 45 minutes on the new alt we bonded, we're going to go back to the pyramid, boys. 64 agility, almost 65, and we're going to be making cash as always. So even if we don't get any good drops from the revs, we'll still make up the cash another way. Boys, check that out. Sigil of Binding. Don't know what that does, but hey, it's a drop. So let me pick that up and we'll look it up and see what it does. Okay, activate the sigil to get a 75% magic accuracy buff. On your next binding spell within the next 12 seconds, the sigil has 30-second cooldown. I mean, 75% accuracy buff is really nice. It'd probably definitely be nice when you have Entangle. For the low level bracket, I don't see it being that good. And I don't really plan on maining this account, so most likely I'll sell it and see what we can get. We got a PKer on us, but he's not that good. Honestly, I could probably kill him. You know what? I'm thinking we're going to fight this guy. Or not. And the guy just fell. Dude, I mean, too easy, bro. Just too easy. We'll use these on him. 90k tele out. I mean, come on, that simple, fellas. Just picked up a rune kite for 47k. Very nice. Oh yes, fellas, the drop to make it all worth it, guys. Dragon plate legs and a blighted super restore. That is what I'm talking about. That drop literally just saved our whole trip. One thing I haven't tried to buy this whole series is a Ceridoman brew. Now, I've been getting some Blighted Super Restores on my alt account that's at Revenants right now. And to go along with those restores, the perfect thing would be Ceridoman Brews. So, let's go ahead and try to buy one for 20k. What? It bought for 5k! Guys, brews are super cheap. They're probably cheap because the restores are probably really expensive. Either way, 5k? Dude, I'm going to stock up on some brews as well. That is going to end our 1 hour done on this new mage alt we made. Time to go meet our main account at the bank and see what the lootations are. Okay, first things first, let's see how much we can get for this, if anything. Literally won't even sell for 10k, so that's a waste. Anyway, moving on. Ulog sold about 200 each. I forgot, guys, we also have the Sigil of the Abyss. This thing gives you 10 times the runes from the Abyss. That's actually nuts. We can't trade it over to our main account anyway. I would love to use it. I can probably buy one on there. But let's see what we can get for this. Wow, I'm actually kind of surprised. Not even 45k. Not even 10k for 10 times the runes. It's actually insane. I'm just going to keep it. All right, now to see the loot. Okay, from that hour, it was 321k. Now, we got so lucky with the dragon play legs. If we didn't get those, I would have been a little sad. I don't know how accurate the prices of everything else are. I can use the food, I can use some of the sacks, the 40 law runes is nice, and definitely getting these blighted super restores is nice. These will go well with the brews we just picked up. Now I'm going to trade over the rest of the stuff that we have because I probably won't use this account for the rest of Deadman Mode. Guys, that safety deposit box though is looking strong. Wow, I put in a blighted restore for 15k and it wouldn't sell. I mean buy. That means these four blighted restores we have are a hot commodity. You guessed it, guys. I'm doing it again. Now, this isn't going to be an alt that's going to be abusing the protection, the 1 hour protection. I've had my fun with that. We've already got a consistent money maker doing the pyramid. I've done lava dragons. I've done revs. Now it is time to craft the perfect mini PK account for this bracket. Our main account TSN is good, but I think that I know the best build with the best sigil for us to be able to tank anyone, out DPS anyone, and wreck everyone. I have not seen this sigil yet. The Sigil of Slaughter, let's inspect it. Pay 30 Slayer points to choose your own Slayer task. You have a 50% chance of a Slayer task kill not to count towards the task while still gaining you Slayer. That is so broken. I mean, I guess because you have to spend 30 points, there's a little drawback, but choose your own task. Honestly, that is insane. With a sigil like that on drop, we might be maining this account. I don't know. We'll see. Time to trade over some supplies from our main. We are going to deck this account out with all range gear. We're going full range, no mage whatsoever. But we're going to be training on long range so we can get range and defense XP all the way up until 40 defense. So I'm going to attune the Sigil of Slaughter because we're definitely going to keep that probably forever. But the sigil that we're choosing to start with is the Sigil of the Ruthless Ranger. Guys, that sigil is so overpowered. Everyone I was fighting, range shoots so fast, and every time it procs, you have a 10% chance to cripple your target's movement, and it deals 5 bleed damage over the next 6 seconds, and then the biggest thing, it drains 30% run energy in that time. 30% of your run gone in 6 seconds, and the damage is doubled against targets with no run energy. So the combination of this whole thing, I mean, honestly, it's a little overpowered. Especially when a Rag Bolter or a Rag MSBer does so much DPS. And that is why that sigil is going to be the key to success on this account. 20 range and 20 def in 18 minutes. Super nice. We're going to go ahead and equip. Boom, boom, boom. Oh yeah, now. Oh yeah, look at that proc. Now we're talking. Next stop, 40 defense and 40 range. And there is 28 range now and 28 defense. Now we can equip the Dorgshin crossbow. Big upgrades. Time to move on to flesh crawlers. Now back to making money on the main account. 66 agility, boys. Big level coming in. We just hit 67 agility and we currently have 120k this trip already. Definitely making some big gains. Guys, check this out. Best trip yet. After we give this to Mr. Simon, we will have 180k cash stack. That is absolutely nuts. I honestly cannot believe they tripled how much money you get from every pyramid top. And take a look at our new range tank alt account. We just got 40 defense and 40 range. Big levels. We can throw on the green dehyde for more accuracy. And now to start working towards 50 range. There it is, guys. We did it. 50 range in the chat. Boom, boom. 40 defense, 50 range at 44 combat. That should give us enough room to get 40 prayer so we can protect from magic and range. Not many people in this combat bracket use melee because you have to get up your attack and strength, and that really doesn't leave any room for any other combat stats or prayer to keep yourself under 50 combat. 69 agility and 150k cash this trip. You know what? I'm going to go for one more. I just ran out of water skins, but we got food, we got brews, and I haven't seen anyone here, so wish me luck. 180k cash trip once again. I'm not going to be stupid. I was going to go for one more, but I have no water skins. There's no point in risking it. I'm just going to head to the bank. All right, time to go for 40 prayer. Oh, all right, second try. Well, we did die, but we did get 41 prayer. It's funny, that was our only goal, and we are right under 50 combat. Thank goodness. Honestly, I'm glad that guy killed me. He saved me from leaving this world. Let's open the starter pack. Just the typical stuff. Oh, boys, a huge level. 70 agility coming in hot. We could do Ceridoman if we wanted to. Who knows, maybe in the future. I'm pretty sure that unlocks agility shortcut at Revenants as well. But I'm going to have to check that. It might be 75. Which actually doesn't matter because I just remembered we have that sigil that gives us permanent plus 5 bonus to every stat. Well, skilling stat, that is. Anyway, 70 agility, technically 75. Man, that is awesome. There it is, 50 magic. This is the perfect account for this combat bracket with the suitable username tanked, but I'm glad it's finally complete. When my main gets back from the trip at Agility Pyramid, I will suit this account up in max gear and we'll be off on our next adventure. And with this, we are about to finish our biggest and most profitable trip to the pyramid yet. Turn this in to Mr. Simon, my good friend. 270k. Dude, let's go. I did some calculations on the combat calculator and I realized I can get 44 prayer on this account. unlocking Protect from Melee and Eagle Eye. All right, no one is here. There's 43. Come on, should be one more. 44. We made it, ladies and gentlemen. This light right here shines down upon the final step to any beginner range tank. When we search the cradle, we get to choose the BIS boots. Ladies and gentlemen, that is going to conclude episode 2 of Deadman Mode series, ending day 1 finally. It has been almost exactly 24 hours, and I don't know how much we played, but we put in some work today. And that is why we are left with these two beautiful accounts. Now, take a look at this. Our main account, TSN, was feeding us GP from the Agility Pyramid all day long. 30k cash per pyramid top. Look at that agility level, guys. 71, 69k till 72. And this account was perfect for it because it had the sigil from the start that gives a +5 permanent boost to all skilling stats. We did not die one time while grinding the Agility Pyramid. We did have a couple close calls, but we actually PK'd two people for some pretty good loot. Speaking of loot, are you ready to see all of our loot that we've gathered and where all that money from the pyramid's been going? Take a look. This is the account we will be maining. It is set up for success combat-wise. Perfect stats, perfect mini range tank, 50 combat flat. I couldn't ask for a better build. It's decked out from head to toe. It's got the Ruthless Ranger sigil. It's got a Slayer sigil that lets you pick your task for 30 points. And just look at that inventory, guys. We got the Visage. Who could forget that from episode 1? But Dragon Plate Legs, I mean, armor, gear, supplies, almost 300k cash, 180 sharks. Ether, look at everything. I'm definitely proud of what we accomplished today. And the coolest part is we didn't swap for even one GP of it. It was all gathered by me, for me. But what my objective is to use it all for is to take us on an adventure. Bring you guys along the way the whole time. I just want to give a huge shout out to everyone who showed support on the last video. It is doing so well and I couldn't have asked for a better turnout. If you're a new subscriber, thank you so much. And if you're a day one, you guys have been there since the beginning. And a huge thanks to you especially. But it's great to meet all the new people. And if you guys enjoyed this episode as well, leave a like, comment, and subscribe. It helps out a ton. And I will see you guys very soon in the episode 3, next up in the Deadman Mode Apocalypse series. Peace.